Hello, my Pisces, and welcome to your weekly tarot reading with me, Miss Machiste. Pisces, this is going to be a reading for the week of October 25th to October 31st. If you're new to my channel, Pisces, welcome. Please do not forget to subscribe. And if you are a current subscriber, welcome back, and I appreciate your support so, so very much. Pisces, this is going to be for the week of October 25th to October 31st. Keep in mind, time is fluid, and everybody has their own divine timing and their own divine order by spirit. This is going to be a general reading, so anything can come out. Love, finances, family, friends, career, school, whatever the case may be. It's going to be general and spiritual. We're going to tap into some angels and some spirit guides to see what messages they have for you here, Pisces, for the week of October 25th to October 31st. Keep in mind, Pisces, that for some of you, this reading may not resonate. You can check out your sun, moon, rising, or Venus sign. Not all messages will resonate with every Pisces out there. So please take what resonates and leave what doesn't, Pisces. And if you are interested on a love-focused reading, all of the mid-month love readings are already out for October. The October love readings for the beginning of the month are out. The weekend love reading was just released if you're watching it in that time frame. So Pisces, let's get into it. For my Pisces, we're going to see what Archangel is with you, Pisces, for this week. So, Spirit. Ooh, the cards are going crazy. All right, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for my Pisces, Spirit. Who's with my Pisces this week of October 25th to October 31st? Spirit, who's with Pisces this week? Which Archangel is with my Pisces? All right, Pisces. Here we go. We have Raziel, Faith. Beautiful. Raziel is the divine mystery. So he helps us with the things that are unknown. So Pisces, with this card coming out, you may have been dealing with some things that have been making you to lose faith. And possibly there are some things that are hidden from you, or, you know, some things that are unknown to you, like the future, that may be causing you to not have much faith in spirit, or causing you to feel like you're not sure what's next. Raziel, he helps us with things that are unknown to us. So whatever you feel is very unknown to you, possibly some of you are trying to regain your faith in spirit, or you have lost your faith in spirit. And this is spirit saying, just because you don't know what's next, and just because you don't know why I did something, it doesn't mean you have to lose faith in me. So Pisces, something may have happened for you recently or a while ago that made you question your faith in spirit. And I feel like this week they're going to prove to you why they're here, why they're around, and why they're helping you, where you will regain a lot more faith in spirit. So for my Pisces who feel as though they have not lost faith, I do feel as though you're going to have a moment this week where you are just like feeling extremely grateful for spirit and definitely raising the faith. I feel like you're going to, I feel like for Pisces, something that was unknown to you is going to make themselves known, is going to make itself known. Because with Raziel coming out, he only comes out when there is some sort of mystery that may be causing you to, is this ghost blocking this? Some sort of mystery that may be causing you to not have faith, you know, like possibly something has happened to you, Pisces, recently, or you may be going through something, maybe a health issue, or you have lost a loved one and you're just like, how is this real? How is this happening to me? I thought all our mighty spirit is there for me, when in reality, the the will of God is not to be questioned. And I feel like Spirit is going to prove to you today why you should keep the faith in them, even when it feels like all else is lost. So beautiful, Pisces. Let's see what angels with you for my Pisces. And for a lot of you Pisces, you may have not lost faith in Spirit, but you may have lost faith in yourself. You may have lost faith in other people. And Raziel, he's gonna show you something this week that you have not seen before. Because we have here card number 2, the Angel of Balance. So we have the Angel of Balance coming through this week as well, helping you balance things in your life. Possibly, you know, it's very hard dealing with friends, family, work, making sure that you are having a healthy diet, making sure that you are really feeling like you're not neglecting a certain area of your life. So Pisces, if you feel like you have just been out of balance, out of whack, really not knowing which way's up, which way's down, a lot is on your plate, you're about to regain your faith in yourself. Because a lot of you Pisces, you may have been taking on a lot and losing faith in yourself. Or possibly you are trying to balance work, friends, family, love, and you may be losing faith in you. But no. Spirit is going to show you why you should continue to believe in yourself. You know, because a lot of you Pisces, you may be starting a new job, because the Angel of Balance, if you see this person in the card, they have a briefcase. So you may be having trouble at your job, like finding balance. Maybe there's a lot of work that has to be done and you're like, I don't know if I can get this done, or I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this job the right way. No, Pisces, change that thought process and say, I'm going to get this done. Even if I don't know how, I'm going to try. Because that's where Raziel comes in. He helps you with the things that you are unsure of, but just are going to go for anyway. So he helps us with taking a step into the unknown and trusting in Spirit and having faith that Spirit will guide us. So let's get a Moonology card for my Pisces, and then we're going to get some tarot. I feel like Pisces, you are about to start believing in yourself again. You really are. You're going to start believing in yourself in all aspects of life. But whatever aspect you feel has really been getting you down, that's where Raziel is going to come in to give you that push. So we have Pisces, believe in the impossible, blue moon. Pisces, we have a blue moon happening on October 31st. And guess what, Pisces? You just got the card. And this is the week I'm doing it for, October 25th to October 31st. Pisces, ooh. Like, that's what I'm saying. If you haven't been, there's a certain area of your life that's been out of balance, that you stopped believing in your capability of manifesting things or getting things done or attracting what you want. So this could be in love, this could be in work, this could be in friends and family. It's like you've lost faith in yourself, Pisces, but Spirit's gonna bring you back into balance. Really bring you back into balance. Because a lot of you Pisces, it's almost like wherever you feel like you just, you know, maybe you just haven't found love and you're like, I'm never going to find love. Maybe you can't find a job that you really like and you're like, when am I ever going to find a job that I love? Whatever it is for you, maybe you were trying to get pregnant and you have a lot of negative fears about that and you feel like it'll never happen to you. Pisces, whatever you feel like is never going to happen to you, think again. Because the things that you believe are not possible for you, or that you are not capable of attracting, you're wrong. And Spirit wants you to use your intuition and believe in yourself. Because any negative thought of yours that is towards yourself in a negative way, sorry Pisces, but it's not true. It's all self sabotage, it's all fears, it's all anxiety. So let's get some tarot for Pisces. I'm gonna use just a Rider White. I wanna get some super specifics here. But you have that blue moon coming out. That's what we have on October 31st. And Pisces, get to manifesting. I always say this, and then I say I'm going to get a manifesting video out, and then it hasn't gone out. November, guys, November, the series is going to start. But Pisces, I'll let you know right now, the first key to manifestation is the way you are wording things. So instead of I will, or I like speak in present tense opposed to past tense. So say you do a manifestation journal. Do not write, I will have love. I will find love. Say, I am finding love. I am love. I have money. You have to speak that you already have it. I'm not gonna go too in depth. That's just the first thing if you're writing things down. So here we go, Pisces. Let's get into it. Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for October 25th to October 31st. Pisces, this could really be about anything. It is so general, but you know, whatever you're thinking about right now that you're just like, yeah, Miss Machise, like, I don't really think this will ever happen for me. Think again. All right, here we go, Pisces. We have justice, karma. Let's go, Pisces. We have the Five of Swords. We have the Seven of Cups. We have the Fool. We have the Three of Swords. And we have the Magician. All right, Pisces. You know, this is very interesting energy here, because Pisces, I feel like this is your karmic justice. You're going to be receiving some karmic reward here. Maybe have some Libra in your chart with justice coming out. But this is karma. This is balance. This is doing what's right. This is doing what's right even when nobody's watching. And Pisces, I feel like I feel like some of you Pisces, this could have to do with love or work. It's kind of like you are dealing with some really nasty energy whatever this means for you Pisces. You were dealing with extremely nasty energy with this Five of Swords. Wherever you were before, there was a lot of arguments. There was a lot of back and forth. There may have been a lot of gossip as well. Pisces, I feel like this energy really caused you pain. I feel like this energy really hurt you. This energy really got you down. I feel like this energy as well confused you a bit, or even a lot. I feel like, Pisces, this could absolutely be love. You may be feeling like, there's no way I'm going to find love. There's no way I'm going to find somebody that's going to recognize me for who I am. But Pisces, that's because you're thinking this way. You must think in the way where it's like, no, 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 no. I attract love. I attract abundance. I am love. I am abundance. But you must believe it. You can say it, but if you don't believe it, believe in the impossible, Pisces. We have the Seven of Cups, Pisces, Scorpio, or Cancer energy. Pisces, you have been very up in the clouds. Mm-hmm. A lot of you Pisces may have been very... I feel like Pisces, whatever this has to do, I feel like you were just so emotionally confused before. I feel like whatever you were dealing with before, you may have been at a workplace that really caused you to... This workplace, it was... Oh, gosh. This old job, wherever the heck you were, it was bad. It caused you pain. It caused you confusion. It caused you conflict, arguments even. And it's almost like you are being gifted with this fool energy, this new beginning. And could be dealing with an Aries, maybe have Aries in your chart. And Spirit is saying, Pisces, this new beginning, wherever you are, in love, in life, in career, wherever, I really feel this is either work or love. It could be friends. You know, you may have felt very, it may have been very hard to balance friends, and there may have been some sort of argument with a friend. That definitely could happen here, but I'm really feeling work and love. But Pisces, this new beginning is your karmic justice. This new beginning is your good karma. So, Pisces, wherever you were before, I feel like a lot of you, it's work. That wherever you were, it's like this, like, just like a toxic workplace. That's how I feel. Very toxic workplace energy. It's kind of like you didn't like going. Let me move this a little bit like that. You can see more with the light. Okay, yeah. You didn't like going here. And for a lot of you Pisces, if this has to do with love, this person, they could have cheated on you. They could have lied to you. They could have broke your heart here. But you have a new beginning coming. And that's why the Magician is here. Gemini energy. But Pisces, this is who you're having faith in again. Yourself. You're having faith in yourself to get things done. Some of you Pisces may be starting your own business. Some of you Pisces may be starting a new job, a new relationship. And it's kind of like this, wherever you used to be, it's like you may still hold on to the confusion of that. You may still be holding on to the confusion that this old relationship caused you to have, or this confusion that this old job caused you to have, where you never knew where you stood exactly. You know, you didn't know, oh, am I going to walk into work today and people are going to have a problem with me? Or am I going to walk into school today and I'm not really, you know, it could be school. I'm really feeling love or work. But we have the Magician here, so you're not going to be confused anymore, Pisces, on who you are. You're not. You're about to remember who you are. Look at this. Look at this. The Fool and the Magician. These two beautiful bright yellows coming through surrounding this Three of Swords. A lot of healing, a lot of faith restored, Pisces. Honestly, I feel like some of you have manifested this new beginning. Not some of you, a lot of you have manifested this new beginning. And it's almost like Spirit is, like I said, for a lot of you Pisces, like if you didn't lose faith in Spirit, you may have lost faith in yourself. And Spirit may be rewarding you for at least keeping the faith with them. And in this way, they can help you believe in yourself again. Believe in what you have to offer and who you are attracting. Because I feel like for a lot of you Pisces, you may have been attracting like lovers who just, they make you feel very emotionally confused. There may be arguments. There may have been like a ghosting situation here as well. Or you may just have been dealt with. You've been maybe have been dealing with people that just confuse the hell out of you. You never know where you stand. And it's just like, it's like draining your energy. But not anymore, Pisces. Not anymore. So let's clarify this for my Pisces Spirit. For Pisces, can you please clarify? For my Pisces, could be, could have some strong air in your chart, possibly is dealing with somebody with air, specifically Libra, but could be a Gemini or Aqua. So for Pisces, all right, Pisces, we have the Ten of Cups. Yes, Pisces. We also have, move these over, the Seven of Pentacles, the Seven of Swords, Death, the King of Wands, the Nine of Pisces. Come on now. Beautiful energy. Very strong Scorpio energy. But Pisces, some of you may have just gone through a divorce or a separation as well. It doesn't have to be, but Pisces, a lot of things were in balance before in your life. A lot. Because look at this. We have Seven of Pentacles, Seven of Cups, and the Seven of Swords. That's in balance. That's not balanced energy there. So Pisces, I feel like you've been just, with the Seven of Pentacles, you've just been waiting. When am I going to find a job that I don't hate? When am I going to find a lover that isn't dating the world, right? When am I going to find, you know, it could be friends. And, you know, I'm really not feeling that. I'm not. Sorry, Pisces. But I feel like you're waiting for some sort of wealth, money, new job, better pay, even at your job. And honestly, I feel like for a lot of you, this is a whole new job. Because I see a lot of, I see an ending and a new beginning. It could be a transformation, but I'll see when I pick up the cards and they'll tell me. But Seven of Pentacles, you've been waiting for this, Pisces. Some of you may have been waiting very impatiently as well, thinking that it would never happen to you. Like I said, some of you lost faith in yourself. Some of you lost that faith in yourself. But look at this, Pisces. Look at this. Good karma coming your way that's going to make you feel like the Ten of Cups. That's going to make you feel full emotional fulfillment. Not just the satisfaction of the Nine of Cups, but the Ten of Cups. Like I said, some of you may have recently gone through a divorce, or some of you may have recently gone through some sort of transformation in your life. Like, I really do feel like if it is a divorce and you're finally getting out there, you're finally believing in yourself again. But we have the Seven of Pentacles. I'm sorry. The Seven of Cups, Seven of Swords, air energy, water energy. Pisces, wherever you were, like I said, whomever you were dealing with before in love, or wherever you were in finances, or wherever you were before, the confusion, the feeling like you're an option, this was all very deceptive-like energy that you were dealing with. I feel like, Pisces, if you were dealing with somebody in love, this person was a liar. This person was just a thief. They wanted to steal your heart and run. For others of you, Pisces, I'm telling you, toxic work environment. You were in that. Ew. Just toxic. Oh my gosh, like, not great at all. But we have death coming through, a transformation, an ending, right? I really do feel like it was strongly, this ending already happened and the transformation is happening now. Scorpio energy. So I feel like a lot of you Pisces, you are going to be, you're definitely starting something new. A lot of you Pisces have already started something new, and you may have lost faith in yourself to get this done, or lost faith in yourself to attract the love you wish to attract. And I feel like something's coming towards you. And you're like, look at this, Pisces, the Three of Swords or the King of Wands. Some of you Pisces, you were dealing with an energy who made you lose your confidence. They made you lose your passion. They made you lose everything. Could have dealt with a fire sign. But not anymore, Pisces. You're regaining your confidence and you're staring at this Three of Swords like, you thought you could get me down. You thought you could ruin me, but you can't. King of Wands as well. He's also very passionate. He's very creative. Some of you may be starting a creative endeavor. Maybe you're into tarot, maybe you're into astrology, maybe you're an artist, maybe you are a musician. It's like the process was not that great for you, but where you're about to be is gonna make it all worth it. That's what I feel, Pisces. The process to get here was hard. It was very hard for you, Pisces. But getting here, it's all worth it. It's all worth it. Some of you dealing with love, you definitely may be dealing with a Gemini, an Aries, or a water sign, fellow Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I have all of the signs out on here, so it could be anybody, but I feel like a lot of you Pisces, you are going to be having wish fulfillment. So this may be new love for you. Maybe there's a second chance as well here for some of you Pisces if there has been a separation with somebody that you share children with or somebody that you are, that you have been with for quite some time. But we do have the Magician to the Nine of Cups. That is wish fulfillment. You have the Nine of Cups and the Ten of Cups, Pisces. So like I said, wish fulfillment. The job that was toxic to you, I really feel like a lot of you Pisces are starting something new. A new job, or maybe you're starting a new business. Maybe you lost faith in yourself. Maybe it wasn't going as fast as you would like it to go. It's about to speed up. Things are about to change. You're about to really sit in your power, Pisces. You are about to remember who you are and the magic that you hold within you. So, Pisces, believe in the impossible, because the impossible is here. The impossible is coming. Raziel is saying to you, you know, you couldn't see it coming, and that's why he came out. Like I said, for a lot of you Pisces, the process to get to this moment was long, painful, tiring, draining, frustrating. It may have been quite some time for you to get to this moment, Pisces, but you're here. It's happening. And I can't, you got the blue moon, Pisces, so you know that saying, once in a blue moon? Yeah, that's what's happening here. Pisces, you really are transforming. You really are. You're like going through some sort of rebirth where you're looking your pain right in the eye and you're saying, you can't do that to me anymore. I vibrate higher than that. And you do, Pisces. Beautiful energy, beautiful week, Pisces. If you would like to book private with me, you can send me an email or you can direct message me on Instagram in the description box below. If you have an Instagram, definitely follow me. I do free card pulls a couple times a week. I can't tell you exactly what day, just when I decide to, but I do give you a warning of that there's going to be free card pulls like later on in the day. And I'll start doing that for YouTube as well. But if you do have an Instagram and you want to get some free card pulls, I will be doing some. What's today? Well, I don't know when you watch this. So I'll definitely be doing some at least three times per week. So if you have Instagram, definitely go follow me and we can interact and do some free card pulls together. So Pisces, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. Beautiful week. You're finding your power and you Pisces, whomever hurt you, whomever caused you this feeling that you're not good enough or that you're not attracting the right people, no, not anymore, Pisces. But that whole mystery of why you were going through what you were going through now, Raziel is about to show you why. Beautiful Pisces. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you very soon. Bye now.